Thank you so much, Saretta. I appreciate the introduction. And what I'd like to do is, for a lot of us, we have been in this doing this for a while, just like Dave Zvenich and XOD and Dwayne and everybody else had mentioned. We are very interested in making sure that everybody has an equitable chance to proceed in and compete for federal work. So everything we've been doing is geared towards that. And today, what I will do is provide an update on where and companies should be able to focus some energies now that we have about 3 years of data to parse through. So without further ado, I am going to present some slides. Please let me know if you see them. And thank you. I think I'll mess this up. I apologize. Next slide, please. So, Mr. Zvenich mentioned, our purpose in the Artificial Intelligence Center of Excellence is to modernize IT across government, and we partner with industry subject matter experts to solve agency problems. Next slide, please. And really, when we think about artificial intelligence, and we have agencies all over the place. What we do is we have some agencies that are still preparing to work on AI projects, conducting some proof of concept experiments. We also have other agencies that have successfully conducted their discovery work, their pilots, and now are at the point where they're scaling up. So lots of opportunity across government for agencies to partner with small businesses. Next slide, please. And really, when we think about, the putting ourselves in the feet of the government, it's the type of questions that we get or the type of challenges that we see in government are, how do I use artificial intelligence to improve automation of compliance with laws, regulations, policies? How do I use software as a service to improve targeted delivery of government services? How do I implement AI tools to integrate legacy and modernized environments? How do I reduce the time to develop and stand up new applications? How do I use AI to help my overtapped workforce? Next slide, please. And those result in typical use cases such as simplifying regulatory and compliance reviews, intelligent assistance chatbots, cases around suicide risk and prevention, automating the movement of data between systems, predictive and proactive equipment maintenance, disease outbreak prediction and modeling, which has been of very importance in the last year or so, cybersecurity and cyber attack prevention, call centers, fraud identification. And really, when we think about it, this is about increasing the speed and efficiency by which we provide service to the public, improved response time, lots of cost avoidance that we can use to modernize our services, and also increase quality and compliance. Next slide, please. So when we look at AI in government, we have some established fields where private sector expertise is still needed. Attended automation, unattended automation, task process management, commonly referred to as RPA, descriptive and diagnostic reporting, predictive and prescriptive analytics. And, we also definitely need support from the private sector in emerging AI fields, where, synthesis recognition, sentiment analysis of speech, image, object, optical mark and text recognition, vision services, chat translation in language services, and then optimization, concept mining, relationship mining, expert systems and knowledge management. That's where we really need a lot of private sector expertise. Next slide, please. So, you know, if you're thinking about how to pitch to government, you know, as a small business, you need to be able to demonstrate ability to sift through enormous volumes of data for answers, improve the accuracy of predictions, inform fact-based decisions, and be able to design learning systems without being explicitly reprogrammed. You have to be able to demonstrate some experience, whether it's commercial or in public sector, involving large data sets that's in streams, or in memory or transactional systems, pattern recognition from historical data, trend analysis, real-time decision support. And most importantly, where we're seeing a lot of growth is bots and or robotic process automation. Next slide, please. Apologies, I had some newer slides which are not showing up right now. Give me a second. Let me bring up some new slides. Present. And, continue. Share and present. So what you're seeing is for virtual assistants, you can see where we're going with just that. We started in FY19 with about $112 million in spending. In contracts in FY20, $662 million, and we're already at double that at about $1.7 billion. When we think about the largest organizations that are, investing in bots, we have Department of Labor, Veterans Administration, Social Security Administration, FCC, and the big pot that you see with GSA, with the $566 million, that is really our category management and our government-wide acquisition vehicles. So the schedules and other vehicles to allow agencies to contract. And the next thing I'd like to present is specifically on RPA and growth. As you can see, year over year growth, it's amazing. In FY17 to FY18, it was 270% growth. FY18 to 19, there was another 300% growth. In FY19 to 20, there's a close to 200% growth. And in just FY21, based on the trends that we're seeing 167% growth just off of FY20 numbers. So, we've already, awarded over $376 million in RPA contracts. Out of which $185 million have already been obligated, and to date, $36 million have been dispersed. So, the big thing, once again, the $139 million is all the GSA vehicles and the GSA schedules that allow agencies to get support for RPA faster and cheaper, with best value. And important things to note, which we're trying to change the dynamic on, 82.4% of the spending was focused in the, in the Metro DC area, the DC, Maryland, VA. And that's probably because most of the agency headquarters are in this area. 86.7% of the contracts were awarded to companies in either in the Northern Virginia or in the Metro New York area. So just things to consider as we're trying to expand, distribute some more of this RPA opportunity. And when we think about what, we've been talking about in previous discussions on emerging technology, especially in artificial intelligence in the last two webinars that we've done, when we think about NAICS codes, the following NAICS codes and the SIN codes are out there. That's really what's driving emerging technology in RPA. You can see it's 30% of the work is in NAICS code 541511. Another 17 is 541512. Another huge chunk is 5415. So really the 5415 series of NAICS codes are where I would encourage small businesses to start focusing on. And really leave you with the thought that the future, as I've seen it, or as I see it, is really deductive and reasoning systems, the virtual systems, the virtual assistants, the bots, the physical assistants, the RPA, the content curation, the knowledge representation, using advanced tools such as graph databases, the mixed media recognition, and really the expert systems. So thank you once again for your time. And with that, I will give it back to Ms. Dyson.